Okay, good afternoon to all. Am I audible to you? Am I audible to all of Okay, so we will start our practical BS2 batch. Last time we have started the assignment number one. Assignment number one, and today only we will work on that assignment, that implementation of create, rename, delete a file using Linux command. Let me share with you the terminal window. Okay, then we want editor, gedit, we want editor. So all you can see the screen where I share the text editor, and that will give you the assignment number one, that is the implementation of create, delete, and rename a file using Linux command. Okay. So while is the one conditional statement that is used here along with ch. Okay. We will check the program whether it is executing or not. I will check it. What I will do, I will So all these operations are there. Now we will try to execute this. So now, how to run the program? Test1.sh. You can see create a file. Our first option is display the content of the file. So I will first of all create the file. Second option, enter the name of the file to create, and I will give the name like PROG1, program one. And here I can write something. This is my first program of OSA, and this is shell script. Shell commands and okay. I can press the Control D. So now I want to display the content of the file. So I can press here one, and the content are here. The content are displayed. This is the list of the directories. Okay, and where you can see the PROG. This PROG is created.
And then I can give the rename option. Number 4 is rename, where it will ask me the original file name. So PROG1. PROG1 is the original file name, and it asks me the enter the new file name. So I will change it to assignment 1. Okay, now I can display the whether it changed. So it is changed. You can see here, it changed. Now for third option, I will give, and I want to delete the file. So they ask me enter the name of the file to delete. So I want to delete the assignment assignment 1. So that is deleted, and I can display it one with one. So you can see there is now no assignment 1. And lastly, I can press the exit. So exit. Fine. Clear. Clear with you? All of you clear with this first assignment of OSA? Now, till the assignment is not completed, some part is remain there. That is, the second part is adding user. So here. Sorry. The second part is adding user. So what I will do? Okay, so I will type here the second part is adding user and giving access. Access rights. Okay, control here. Here now I change the title and I add this point there, giving access right and adding user and giving access right. So उसी program में आपको क्या करना है, user add करना है and access right उसको देना है, giving access right. उसके पहले let me ask you one thing, that whether everybody clear with this initial part of the program, create a file, rename the file, delete the file, ये सब चीजें आपको clear हो गई क्या? Anybody is having problem with the clear, rename, delete? Is there any problem in create, rename, delete? Nobody is replying. No problem. Okay. Yeah. So now, sorry. Okay. So now the second part is adding user and giving access right. So what is the access right? First of all, we'll see what is access right. Access right means what? So there are three types of access right given to the file. Okay. Like read, write, execute, and there are three types of user. User is the owner, group owner, and the other user. Okay. So we will try to give the access. With command chmod. Here, dear student, first of all, you try to understand there are three types of user. Okay. So what I will do, I will try to explain this thing with sharing the screen so that you can understand it clearly. So, see, there are three types of user, that is owner, group owner, and author. Okay. So, owner is the file's owner, group owner is the user who are the member of the file's group, and author user who are neither the file's owner nor the member of the file group. That is author. And what permissions now we want to give to the user? That is, either we can add the permission or we can remove the permission, and or we can specify the mode. Specified are to be made the extract modes for specified classes, that is equal to, plus, minus, and equal to. So three types of operators are there. First one is the plus, second one is the minus, third one is the equal to. Now, and what are the three types of permission? Read, write, and execute. That is, the read, R stand for permission to read the file, W stand for permission to write the file or delete the file, and X stand for permission to execute the file or, in the case of directory, search it. Let me again share with you the screen, terminal window. Now here we are going to learn the command chmod. So first of all, I will do the man chmod. and it gives you change the file mode bit. Okay, you can change the file mode bit. What it gives the information, this manual page document, the GNU version of the CH mode, and you can see various information about this CH mode there, where hyphen C you can use to change. Okay, hyphen F it used to silent, hyphen V is the verbose. Okay, many options are there. What we will do, we will try to execute this command. Now what is the syntax of this command? So see, mujhe kya karna hai ki, first of all I will how to see the existing permission of the file, which command is used to see the permission of the file, current existing permission of the file.
How I can see the permission which are currently associated with the file? अभी जो मेरे कंप्यूटर में जो फाइल्स है उसके मुझे परमिशन देखने है, कौन से यूजर को कौन सी परमिशन है, तो मैं कौन सी कमांड दे सकता हूँ? ओके, एनीबडी? ls minus l, correct. So you are saying that ls minus l,
so ls hyphen l it is probably. So it is ls hyphen l, correct. So you can see on the screen, so after giving this command I got the long list of the files and the directories where four files are there. कितने files हैं अभी इस ls hyphen l देखकर मुझे मालूम हो गया है कि there are assignment1.sh, test1.2.3, test1.sh, four files are there, and this name of the user is icon, name of the user is icon, and group owner is icon. So this is having icon owner is having read write. Group owner is having read write execute, others are having read write execute. Okay, but if you see the test, something is different there. The owner is having read write, group owner is having read only, and this author is having read only. So now I want to change. So change karne ke liye kya command hai? chmod. To mujhe किसकी परमिशन चेंज करनी है? मुझे चेंज करनी है यूजर की. सो आई विल गिव यू. ओके, तो मुझे क्या करना है, मुझे उसे एग्जीक्यूट परमिशन देनी है. एग्जीक्यूट मतलब एक्स देना है. सो आई कैन ऐड हियर एक्स. ओके, और किसके लिए करना है मुझे, कौन से फाइल के लिए करना है? टेस्ट. सो एवरीबडी सी द सिंटैक्स हाउ आई राइट इट. chmod इज द कमांड, U is the user, plus is the operator because I am adding the permission to the user. X is the execute permission. और किसके लिए मैं कर रहा हूँ? ये test के लिए कर रहा हूँ. So if I give this command and if I press enter, then okay, अभी मैंने enter press किया है. तो आप यहाँ पे मैंने शुरू में आपको ls minus l करके दिखाया था. तो user को execute permission नहीं है. You can see, still it is on your screen. User को execute permission नहीं है, लेकिन हमने chmod command अभी दे दी है, तो उसे execute permission आ चुकी है. तो ये check करने के लिए मुझे क्या करना पड़ेगा? ls minus l वापस देना पड़ेगा. So you can see now, test is having, the user is having execute permission, जो शुरू में नहीं थी. डिफरेंस सबको दिखाई दे रहा है क्या? आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? यस प्रथमेश, यस सुवाश, इज इट क्लियर टू यू? द अदर यूजर कैन द यस अदर अदर स्टूडेंट अभय लहारे, आदित्य गोनकर, एवरीबडी इज गेटिंग द कमांड chmod. अजय, आकाश, आशीष, अविनाश, चेतन, दर्शन, कृष्णा, कुणाल,
Prathamesh, then Sandesh, Sanket, Siddhant, Suhash, and Yuvraj. Yes, Yuvraj, kindly unmute your audio.
Yes, sir.
The command is clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Sanket? Sanket, kindly unmute your audio. Sanket? Sanket Zappe is there. Sandesh More? Sandesh? Kunal Joshi? Kunal? Kunal, are you there?
Yes, sir.
So you clear with the command?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay, see ya. Now, so dear student, you can notice here, it's very simple command, chmod. Humne kya kiya tha ki chmod. So uska syntax ek bar, once you see the syntax, chmod space U. U stand for? U stand for?
User.
Correct. Plus stand for? Plus stand for?
Adding permission.
Very good. X stand for X. What is X?
Execute.
Very good. And what is the last one? Test?
File name.
Very good. So that is the meaning of this command, that we want to change the mode, change the permission of user. That means we are adding the permission, which permission? Execute permission. And we are doing this for test file. Now I will remove the permission. Now I will remove the permission. See here. So I again use the command chmod. So first of all, we will ls-l. Okay. And now I will use the command chmod u minus x, for which file? Test. If I press enter, and if again we give the command ls-l, so you can see here the permission is now removed. Execute permission is removed. Okay, because I use the subtraction, that is a minus sign here. Minus x means I want to remove the permission. I add the permission, now I remove the permission. Is this thing clear to everybody? Chmod?
Yes.
Very good. Now same thing is for group owner. So main abhi kya karta hu ki group owner ke liye bhi aapko dikhata hu. Suppose now we clear this, and if I give the command ls-l, so I got this. So now currently you can see here the test is a file. Test. So uske group owner ko kaun si permission hai abhi? Currently which permission is associated with group owner?
Read permission.
R stand for read. So currently the group owner is having read permission. Okay. Now what we will do? We will try to change the permission. So chmod, so mujhe group ke liye karna hai, to mujhe g use karna padega, g plus w test. Okay, and now I can again give the ls minus l, so you can see, so the write permission, this rw, initially there was no w, now here the write permission is given. So that means the author can perform the write operation. Okay. Now, similarly, I want to give the execute permission to group owner. So I can give your X and command is test hyphen L. So you can see here. The authors can now execute X. Other means the group owner.
the group owner can now execute the file. Okay. This thing is clear to everybody? What is G here? What is G? What is G? Group owner. What is plus?
Adding permission.
What is X?
Execute.
And paste is the name of the file. So similarly, you can remove the permission. So you can remove the permission from group owner X paste. Okay. Press enter. LS minus L. So you can see it. The group owner is now not able to execute. So this is with a group. Now I will show you with the other user. So suppose first of all we give the command X. Now test. Other user is having which permission for test file?
Read permission.
And okay. Now I want to give the execute permission. So I can give chmod O plus X to test. Okay. Now you can see here. Test. Other user can execute. Other user can execute the test file. This thing is clear to everybody?
Yes.
Very good. So this is a part of your assignment number one, that we want to give the read, write and execute permission to the file. ओके आपको प्रोग्राम में थोड़ा सा मॉडिफाई करना पड़ेगा और ये रीड राइट एग्जीक्यूट परमिशन बाय यूजिंग chmod कमांड देनी पड़ेगी. ओके सो दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग कमांड. ओके Now we know that in Linux there are different user like owner, okay, and the group owner and the other, and they are having read, write and execute permission. Okay. So now we want to see the another command, that is the chown. Okay, chown. I will man chown. Sorry, man chown. So what is this? Change the file owner and group. Change the file owner and the group. How we can do this? I give the command cho, that is change the file owner and the group. So so here, now I will try it for one command. Here, now who is the owner here? Who is the owner? Icon is the owner, na? We require a super user login, so what is the password of my so here I should recover the password of my super user. For long back I am not using the Linux on my laptop, personal laptop, so that's why that password is not and there is a option that I can recover the password. Okay, but surely I will recover the password. Now what I want to show you that there is a chown command, chown, that can change the owner for the file. Okay, chown. Okay, there is a change the file owner and the group owner. So what you do, you first of all read all these things. Okay, and meanwhile I will recover the password. all you continue to read the content of that ch own. Okay. Meanwhile, the second part is that is the user add command. I need to explain the user add command also. So for that user add command, user add command can be explained with the help of super user only. So I want to recover the password of my super user. So meanwhile, you just keep on reading the content of that. Okay, so dear student, you be there. Okay, aapko log out nahi karna hai. What I am doing now, to change the my root password, I am restarting my machine. So 17 students are here. You kindly be in the meeting. Don't leave the meeting right now. Okay, aapko meeting se exit nahi hona hai. Main khud exit hone wala hu aur ek 2 minutes ke baad main wapas enter karunga. Okay, so don't go anywhere, you be there.
Okay, welcome back to all of you. See now, before the initial part, we try to execute the chmod command. Okay. Now, we are having one more part, that is, let me open the gedit. The online practical will require some stuff. So suppose this is your program, and that is adding a user. How to add a user? So that I will show you now. How to add a user on Linux? So that we need to do. So now there is a command man. See, I will first of all use the man user add. Okay. So it is used to create a new user or update the default new user information. Here you can read user add command is used to create the new user. Now how to create a new user? Suppose I give the command, and who can do this? Suppose I give the command user add, and I want to add the user like a student one. Okay, student one is the name of that user. Okay, so here I can use my name also. Suppose for example Anil, user add Anil. Then it gives me the error that permission denied, because this this icon, now this is one user, my user, is not having a permission to create a new user. So who is having a permission to create a new user? So no doubt about that. Who is having a permission to create new user, or who can able to create a user in your system? Who is having that permission? Who is having permission to create a user in the system? So that is a root. Okay, correct, absolutely right. Root means administrator. Administrator is having a permission to create a user, and who is the administrator of our system? So root is the administrator of our system. Root user is the administrator of our system. So what I can do, I can switch to that user now. When I want a super user, su is the command to change to super user. So su, and I press enter, so it will ask me the password of super user. So I just now recovered the password. So this is my super user, that is root. You can see here, root is my now super user. And now if I give the command user add Anil, okay, user add Anil, and it will ask me, so it is created now, the user add Anil, that is created. Okay, the new user is created. So I need to give the password. पासवर्ड मुझे इस नए यूजर को पासवर्ड देना पड़ेगा. सो कमांड इज पास डब्ल्यू डी अनिल. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द पासवर्ड आई कैन गिव? आई कैन गिव द पासवर्ड लाइक 1 2 3. ओके, सो दिस इज द पासवर्ड आई गिवन सक्सेसफुल. सो new user is created. Okay, so how I can come to know who is the current user? So that is a icon in the computer that is currently logging. Now how to check? Now jab main machine reboot karunga, abhi reboot, so it will ask me, or it will show me the new user also. That new user along with my previous user icon and new user is Anil. So I can log on by using that Anil now. So मैं अभी Google Meet में आपको ये दिखा नहीं सकता कि मैंने मशीन रिस्टार्ट किया तो मुझे वो शुरू में, मतलब स्टार्टिंग में मुझे यूजर पूछेगा लॉग इन करने के लिए. तो मैं अभी प्रैक्टिकली, जब आप कल आएंगे तो फिर ऑफलाइन प्रैक्टिकल में आपको ये दिखाना पड़ेगा. आप भी ये कर सकते हैं, आपको सिर्फ रूट का पासवर्ड समझ मैंने कहा था आपको कि मेरा रूट का पासवर्ड मैं भूल गया था, बिकॉज मैंने भाई ये लॉन्ग बैक आई वर्क ऑन द विंडोज ओनली, ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई वो मैंने रिकवर किया अभी, मैंने जो ब्रेक लिया था एक 15 मिनट का, उस दौरान मैंने रूट का पासवर्ड रिकवर करके नाउ आई एम यूज एबल टू क्रिएट अ न्यू यूजर, मैंने यूजर क्रिएट किया, लेकिन वो आपको दिखाने के लिए मुझे रिबूट करना पड़ेगा सिस्टम, सिस्टम रिबूट करके फिर आपको वहाँ पे फर्स्ट स्क्रीन पे दिखाई देगा कि नाउ देर आर टू यूजर्स, आईकॉन इज द फर्स्ट यूजर एंड दैट अनिल इज द सेकंड यूजर, ओके, तो ये मैं आपको गूगल मीट में नहीं दिखा सकता, ये आपको खुद ट्राई करना पड़ेगा, ओके, तो स्टिल चेक here now there is one command /etc/passwd, तो आपको ये अभी कमांड मैंने रन करके दिखाई है लेकिन आपको समझ में नहीं आएगा, इट गिव्स द इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट इट इज अ passwd इज द पासवर्ड फाइल, कैट कमांड का मालूम है आपको यूज क्या है, कैट कमांड डिस्प्ले द कंटेंट ऑफ फाइल, सो हियर इट डिस्प्ले द username of all the users which are currently logged on. So here you can see in the last, so there is a user Anil, icon and Anil. So icon is the initial user and this Anil is the new user that is created. Okay, so that is one way to recognize whether users are created or not. Okay. So what we will do, I will try to log in, exit karta hu main abhi, exit, so I come back to the my normal user, exit karke maine kya kiya ki main normal user pe aa gaya, icon pe aa gaya, to yahan pe main kya karta hu ki sudo sudo login anil password of Anil is 123. Okay, yes. So yahan pe aap dekh sakte hain ki now I log search directory 13 package are uploaded. Okay. Now this is the Anil folder. Yahan pe main abhi ye sab kuch dikha raha hu. That is Anil mein maine login kiya na. So currently I am in Anil. Can exit from here. I give the ls, then I am here on icon. Command that only shows the icon.
So this is the way to see it that slash etc slash password, that command is there. Apart from that, is there any way to display the login user? तो आपको ये वापस login करके देखना पड़ेगा. So the student that is there, okay, so you have to boot the system and then only you can able to see the new user which is created. Now we want to add these two commands in our program. Okay, so office mein kya karta hu ki aapko aapke program mein leke jata hu. So this is your program. तो उसे मॉडिफाई करने के बाद अभी आप तो क्या करना है आपको यहाँ पे इको एडिंग यूजर टू द सिस्टम तो आपका जो असाइनमेंट नंबर वन है वो टाइटल में अभी फुलफिल कर रहा हूँ कि आपको आपने फाइल क्रिएट की, रिनेम की, डिलीट की. सेकंड पार्ट जो था आपको यूजर ऐड करना है और उसे परमिशन देना है. सो लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल 6 7 7 व्हाट विल बी द दैट इज द फिफ्थ केस इज एडिंग यूजर ना. Try to execute echo. Enter the name of the new user. आपको जिस नाम से यूजर बनाना है उसका नाम देना पड़ेगा. And what I can do, I can read it with variable like user one. Okay, मैं उसको variable देता हूँ user one. And now what you need to do is आपको super user login करना पड़ेगा ना, normal user नहीं करेगा ये. आप इसके लिए क्या कर सकते हैं, super user के लिए आप एक command क्या देंगे आप? तो su su so I can press enter now. su के बाद enter आएगा. It will ask me the password. Can enter the password and then I can use the command add user. Add user no? So for user के बाद ये add user नहीं ले रहा है. यूजर एड लेगा, नहीं लेगा सुपर यूजर. एड पर एड डॉलर password. We will try whether it is executing or not. Let's check. Clear screen. I will try to execute first and then I will show you. Test 1000. Test 1. test1.sh and then number option is adding the user to the system. Enter the name of the user to add. So I will give you next. Sorry, password. My password le liya hai abhi. It will ask me the password. Password, suppose I give the password like user. So your choice na for see karna padega sh test1.sh. adding the user to the system is the first step. Then enter the name of the new user. So I give the name Anil2. It is asking the password of super user na, say super user ka password puch raha hai. Yes. So, okay. Super user mein jaane ke baad wo kya karna chahiye tha usne? User add command execute karne chahiye thi. Okay. Add. Okay, so we need some extra time to execute all these things. Okay, so
today I hope that you will able to understand what is this
user add and password pass wd command. Okay, what I will do, I will share the screen with you once again. This terminal window, then here. So what I did, I changed the super user by my password. Okay, and I created the user here by using user add command. User add. So I need to give the username. So maine diya tha yahan pe. Okay, and if I press enter, then it will ask me the. तो क्रिएट करने के बाद आपको पासवर्ड देना पड़ेगा हर एक यूजर को पासवर्ड देने के लिए पास डब्ल्यूडी एंड यूजर ओके सो लाइक दिस तो मैंने अनिल नाम बनाया था तो मैं पासवर्ड चेंज कर सकता हूँ अनिल का तो आई कैन पास डब्ल्यूडी लाइक दिस ये करके उसके बाद हमने देखा सी एच मोड कमांड देखी सी एच मोड यू प्लस एक्स एंड नेम ऑफ द फाइल ओके सो यू कैन चेंज द नेम ऑफ द फाइल सो दिस वॉज इज सफिशिएंट फॉर दिस प्रैक्टिकल If you try it and you try to execute this user add command and pass wd command along with the ch mode here I declare that our first practical first program in all respect is completed okay so you try to write a write up of this assignment number 1 you try to execute first of all the try to create file rename file delete file then try to add the user and try to change the access permission Okay, if you are having any doubts or any problem, then you can ask me at any time. So I will end the meeting. Thank you very much for joining. You mark the attendance there.